previous lecture, as you know, that we started to discuss the concrete, wherein we have seen the definition of the durability of the concrete, then factors affecting the durability of the concrete, and what are the different criteria based on which we can classify a particular concrete as durable in nature. And after that, we have seen the chemical durability, and in that case, we have discussed two cases, where the first type is the carbonation, and second is the corrosion. In this particular lecture, we are going to discuss regarding the corrosion of reinforcement, which is what we can say a sub-domain. So let us start today's lecture, where we try and understand the process through which the corrosion of reinforcement is initiated and how it is going to affect the service life of the concrete. So basically, as you can see over here, that this particular phenomena is going to involve two types of materials. That is, two types of elements are going to be present, where first is going to be an electrolyte and second is going to be the metallic connection. And due to presence of these two materials, basic materials only, the process can be initiated of corrosion of concrete, right? So in reinforced concrete, the rebar may have many separate areas in different energy levels. Concrete acts as an electrolyte, and the metallic connection is provided by means of fire ties, chair supports, or the other types of rebar itself, right? So if you look at the schematic representation, where you can see the two stages that are taking place, where first stage is the electrochemical process and second is the electrochemical corrosion, where you can see that first of all, the reinforcement, there is a passive layer that is going to be formed on the surface of the reinforcement. Then this passive layer is broken due to any of these attacks that is taking place, and once this is broken, then as a result of that, the direct contact of the reinforcement with the surrounding atmosphere takes place, and as a result of that, from there on, the process of corrosion is initiated, right? So now if we look at the process that is taking place, then basically we can say that two processes are taking, where first of the two types of reaction is taking. Where the first reaction is the anodic reaction and second reaction is the cathodic reaction. So as far as the anodic reaction is there, you can see that Fe plus Fe2 plus ion is, that is Fe2 plus, that is ion, is going to be the most important ingredient over here. And this Fe2 plus is going to release the electrons, and then as a result of that, it is going to come in contact with the hydroxyl ion. As a result of that, the ferric hydroxide is. Further, this ferric hydroxide is going to react with water, and then it is going to react with the presence of oxygen. Then as a result of that, ferrous hydroxide is going to be. And along with that, if you look at the cathodic reaction that is going to be there, then you can see that in this particular case, in the cathodic reaction, four hydroxyl ions are going to be remaining as the byproduct. And as we have seen earlier, that in this process of carbonation or the other processes, the hydroxyl ions are consumed, and as a result of that, the pH value is reduced. And once the pH value is reduced, then the initiation of different types of problems in the concrete is started, right? However, if we look at the possibilities in which the corrosion is likely to start, then we can say that if the concrete is totally dry, then also the possibility of corrosion is null. And if the relative humidity in concrete is also around 60%, then also the possibility of corrosion starting is going to be very less. Then the question comes is, then what is the scenario under which the concrete is likely to undergo the process of corrosion? Then in that case, we can say that if the concrete is fully immersed also, that is, if the reinforcement is fully immersed in water also, then in that case also the possibility of corrosion is not. But there is a specific range, if the relative humidity is in this particular range, then as a result of that, the corrosion process is likely to be initiated, and that range is between 70 to 80%. That is, if the relative humidity of the concrete is between 70 to 80%, then it is best suited to start the process of corrosion of reinforcement. Right? So if we talk about the process that happens once this corrosion of reinforcement is initiated, then basically what happens is that the passive layer, as I have said, that is formed around the reinforcement due to the alkalinity of the concrete is lost, or that is disturbed or fractured, right? Due to the presence of these H2CO3 ions, and that are there in the concrete. So once this particular thing happens, the pH value is reduced. Now how much is the pH value? If it is reduced, then as a result of that, the carbonation, and as a result of that, the corrosion of reinforcement is likely to. Then it is said that when the pH value is reduced below 8.3, then in that case the passive layer is destroyed, and as a result of that, the corrosion takes place, right? And the problem of corrosion occupies a volume which is as much as 6 times the original volume of this. That is, again, as I said, that in all these processes that are said, the main problem is that due to the expansion of the volume, the problems are started. Due to this expansion, the cracking will take place. From the expansion, the spalling will take place, and then as a result of that, the delamination. In all the processes, the problem is there. that due to this reaction that is taking place, some kind of activity takes place, and as a result of that, the resultant byproduct that we have is going to have a larger volume. And since the space is limited, so it is going to try and occupy the space by breaking through the intermolecular bonding. And once it is going to try and break the intermolecular bonding, then as a result of that, the core strength of the material is going to be getting reduced, right? So here also you can see that the increase in volume is almost 6 times. So when the increase in volume is almost 6 times, then as a result of that, it is likely to occupy a similar kind of space in the concrete structure also. And if that space is not available, then as a result of that, it will exert pressure on the surrounding surface. And as a result of this pressure that is exerted, the cracking is initiated, and from the cracking, the swelling, and then the delamination to take. So if you look at the figure where the entire effect of corrosion on the surrounding structure of the concrete is shown, then in the first stage, you can see that the cracking phenomena is there. In the second stage, the spalling of the surface is taking place. In the third stage, the delamination of the surface. That is, what is going to happen is that if the concrete is not dense enough in nature, or if it is going to be porous in nature, then as a result of that, from the surface, it is going to try and reach the inner part of the inner surface of the reinforcement through the cracks that are developed on the surface, right? So, and as a result of that, what is going to happen is that some minor cracks will be observed on the surface. Then slowly, again, it is going to increase in the volume, and once it is going to increase further in the volume, then you can see that the spalling of concrete will take place. And later on, the stage will come where the delamination of the concrete will also take place. So if you summarize the entire process of corrosion of reinforcement, then we can say that first of all, the passive layer is broken. Then in the second case, the pH value is reduced to below 8. Then there is increase in the volume. Due to this increase in the volume, the cracking takes place. From the cracking, the spalling of concrete takes place. And lastly, the delamination of the surface takes place. Right? So now the question that comes to us is that how do we control this corrosion? Right? So we do know about certain basic what you can say general phenomena, but if we talk about specific engineering phenomena that can be applied to control this process of corrosion, then we have 5 options. Which is this 5 options? The first option is the metallurgical method. Second is corrosion inhibitor. Third is galvanizing of reinforcement. Fourth is cathodic protection, and fifth one is the what you can say the coating of reinforcement. Now all these options may not be available to you in all around the world. Some specific regions are following certain methods, and some regions are following certain methods based on the economical needs, right? But however, we are just giving you a brief over here regarding all the different 5 options that are there that can be used to control the reinforcement, corrosion of the reinforcement. First is that if we talk about the metallurgical method. So when you talk about metallurgical method, then it can be said that steel can be made more corrosion resistant by altering its structure through the metallurgical processes, such as the quenching of bars. Quenching of hot bars by water jets, or putting the hot bars in a series of water baths. That is, as soon as these you can see, because we all know the chemical process or the process through which the reinforcing bars are formed. So when they are hot in nature or hot in temperature, then if you place this particular or you pass this bar through these what you can say the water jets or water baths, then as a result of that, the basic structure of the reinforcement is altered somewhat, and as a result of that, it is likely to provide higher resistance to the corrosion. Second is the corrosion inhibitors. That is, if you introduce some minerals or some chemicals in the concrete, as a result of which the process of initiation of corrosion can be delayed, then these particular types of minerals are known as corrosion inhibitors. And what are the example of these corrosion inhibitors? Then corrosion can be prevented or delayed by chemical methods by using certain corrosion inhibiting chemicals such as the nitrites, the phosphates, and the benzonates. And the general practice is that calcium nitrate is one of the minerals that is used to be mixed in during the mixing of the concrete before placing the concrete around the reinforcement. So if you are using these corrosion inhibitors, then as a result of that, the delay will not ensure that it is going to be 100% corrosion proof, right? But it will delay the process. That is, for example, if the corrosion is likely to start in 5 years, then in that case, the corrosion inhibitors are used, then the life cycle from 5 years can be increased to 7 or 8 years, right? Then galvanizing of reinforcement. Now, in case of galvanizing also, we know that additional layer of zinc is formed. So whenever this additional layer of zinc is formed, then as a result of that, what is going to happen is that whenever the concrete cracking is going to take place and the foreign minerals are trying to reach the surface of the concrete reinforcement surface, then first they are going to interact with the zinc. and then later on with the passive layer of reinforcement and then the reinforcement itself. So again, what you can see, the thickness and thickening of the reinforcement is going to take place, and as a result of this thickening, the chances are there that the process of corrosion is going to, initiation of corrosion in the reinforcement can be delayed. Then the fourth option is regarding the cathodic protection. Now, in case of cathodic protection also, it is going to be an expensive method which is not generally used in all the countries. But it is one of the methods where by some physical process, you will be able to control the corrosion or delay the corrosion of reinforcement, right? And lastly is the coating of the reinforcement. And we talk about the coating of the reinforcement. The object of coating of the reinforcement is to introduce an additional barrier, just like in case of corrosion inhibitor or in case of galvanizing of the reinforcement. Similarly, here in case of coating of reinforcement also, you are introducing an additional layer above the passive layer. So what is going to happen is that first the additional layer has to be broken, then the passive layer has to be broken, and then the air or the surrounding minerals can come in contact with the reinforcement, and then the process of corrosion may likely take, right? So in this case, fusion based epoxy coating of reinforcing bars can be done, and as a result of that, the direct contact of reinforcement surface with the surrounding concrete can be avoided, and as a result of that, the process or the initiation of corrosion can be delayed for a longer, larger period of time, right? I hope you have understood the entire process or entire phenomena that is involved in the corrosion, and how what are the different criteria and how the concrete surface is going to react when corrosion of reinforcement is going to take. And lastly, we have also seen what are the different methods through which we can control the corrosion of reinforcement. Right? Stay tuned for the further lecture.